I thought I was going to be murdered my entire childhood. In high school, people were like, what are your top three colleges? I was like, top three colleges? I thought I would be dead in a trunk with my hand hanging out of the taillight by now. I went to college for the whole time. Holy shit, right? I just got a letter from my college, which was fun, because mail, you know? So I open up the letter, and they said, hey, John, it's college. You remember? I said, yes, of course. And then they said, how did they phrase it? Then they said, give us some money as a gift. We want a gift, but only if it's money. I found this peculiar. Because you see, what had happened, New York, was that when I was a student, you see, I had paid them a tuition money. Every semester, two semesters a year, for 4 years. I don't remember exactly what it was, but rounding up, back in 1999 dollars, it was about $15,000 a semester, two semesters a year, for 4 years. So it was about $30,000 a year for 4 years. So it was about $120,000, okay? So roughly speaking, I gave my college about $120,000, okay? So you might say that I already gave them $120,000, and now you have the audacity to ask me for more money? What kind of a cokehead relative? What kind of a cokehead relative is my college? You spent it already! I gave you more money than the Civil War cost, and you fucking spent it already! Where's my money? I felt like Jimmy Stewart in It's a Wonderful Life when he's screaming at his Uncle Billy. I was like, where's the money? Where's that money, you fat motherfucker? Where's my money? Stay down on the ground. Stay down on the ground, you motherfucker. That's not the dialogue, but do y'all remember that scene from It's a Wonderful Life? Great movie. Frank Capra, 1946. $120,000. And I have friends I went to college with, and they're like, oh, you should donate and be a good alumnus. And they wear shirts that say school. And it's like, look, if you're an adult still giving money to your college, college is a $120,000 hooker, and you are an idiot who fell in love with her. She's not gonna do anything else for you. It's done. In their letter, they were like, hey, it's been a while since you've given us money. I was like, hey, it's been a while since you've housed and taught me. I thought our transaction was over. I gave you $120,000, and you gave me like a weird cinder block room with a Reservoir Dogs poster on it. And the first real heartbreak of my life, and probably HPV, and then we called it a day. Probably. Also, what did I get for my money? What is college? Stop going till we figure it out. Because I went to college, I have no idea what it was. I went to college, I was 18 years old, I looked like I was 11. I lived like a goddamn Ninja Turtle. I didn't drink water the entire time. I lived on cigarettes and alcohol and Adderall. College was like a four-year game show called Do My Friends Hate Me or Do I Just Need to Go to Sleep? But instead of winning money, you lose $120,000. By the way, I agreed to give them $120,000 when I was 17 years old. With no attorney present. That's illegal. They tricked me. They tricked me like Brendan Dassey on Making a Murderer. They tricked me like poor Brendan. They pulled me out of high school. I was in sweatpants all confused. Two guys in clip-on ties are like, come on, son, do the right thing. Sign here and you'll be an English major. I was like, okay. Yes, you heard me. An English major. I paid $120,000. How dare you clap? How dare you clap for the worst financial decision I ever made in my life? I paid $120,000 for someone to tell me to go read Jane Austen, and then I didn't. That's the worst use of $120,000 I can possibly fathom. Other than if you, like, bought a duffel bag of fake cocaine. No, I take it back. That's a better use of the money. Because I know you'd be disappointed when you open up the duffel bag and you realize it's not real cocaine. It's like powdered baby aspirin or whatever they do. But at least you have baby aspirin. And maybe you have a baby. And one day your baby goes, "Oh, my head." And you go, "Hey, I got something for you. Come here, little guy." And you know, you dump it out on a mirror. You make it nice for the baby. You make it nice. You cut it up into lines with your laundry cart or whatever, and you make it nice, and your baby takes his sippy cup straw, and he holds it in his little ravioli-sized baby fist, and he leans over, and he snorts up the baby aspirin, and he gets rid of his baby headache, plus you get a duffel bag. That is way better than walking across a stage at graduation, hungover in a gown, to accept a certificate for reading books that I didn't read. Strolling across a stage, the sun in my eyes, my family watching as I sweat vodka and ecstasy to receive a 4-year degree in a language that I already spoke.